Good afternoon. The first item of business is time for reflection. And our time for reflection leader today is Alistair Bennett, Chief Executive, Bethany Christian Trust.
Presiding Officer, members of the Scottish Parliament, thank you for the invitation to address you as you begin this new term. At the National Prayer Breakfast in June, I joined MSPs from across political parties. Together, we prayed for our nation. In 1983, in Leith, Edinburgh, prayer was the catalyst that launched Bethany Christian Trust. For 40 years, our staff and volunteers have sought to love, serve, and value people on the margins, labouring together with many partners in our vision of ending homelessness. We welcome the Scottish Parliament's commitment to addressing homelessness, a major social issue requiring a holistic approach. Bethany works to prevent homelessness, intervene in crisis, and support people in their own homes through over 30 services across Scotland. And through Christ's love in action, we have seen countless lives changed and circumstances changed, yet our work is far from over. What makes change possible? There was a young man called Scott who also grew up near Leith. He was struggling. He fell into a bad rut and lost his way. He left the family home, ending up making some big mistakes and damaging his mind through a cocktail of substance abuse. No money, no work, no motivation. By 19, deep depression had taken hold of him, and vice-like paranoia had gripped his mind. Scott needed change. There was someone praying for him, his mother. She prayed fervently, nightly, month after month, eventually exclaiming, "Lord, I surrender what happens to him as long as he's yours." God answered. That young man found forgiveness, healing, and hope. His life was turned around, his heart was lifted, and his mind was healed. Why? Because one woman believed in the good news of Jesus Christ to change lives. She surrendered to God in prayer. My middle name is Scott, and that young man was me just over 30 years ago. Change is possible. What about a nation? Can a nation be changed? Jesus Christ taught that change is not only possible, but necessary, declaring the kingdom of God has come near. Turn around and believe the good news. We all have a part to play in transforming society through our prayers, our attitudes, and our actions. What could it mean for us today if we collectively heed Jesus' invitation to turn around, trust in his unconditional love, and surrender to God in prayer? Truly, it could transform the nation. Thank you.